What is up? So, since Valentine's Day is in February, and I hate Valentine's Day, I thought I would do something different other than all of the pink and lovey-dovey makeup looks. So, since spring training for baseball starts in February, I'm going to put out a makeup look every day for February. And the lighting kind of sucks. One, backlit, so that sucks. Two, even though I'm facing the window, I'm only on the 8th floor out of 20, so I don't get the best light. And Minneapolis, apparently, and the whole state of Minnesota, doesn't believe in the sun for more than like 3 days a month, and we already had those 3 days. So we'll see how it goes. So for a navy blue, I think I'm gonna mix shades Spooky and Cola and kind of hope that it makes a navy-ish blue. Oh god, I'm nervous. Oh, okay. Let's see, okay, if I mix it on my hand first, maybe? All right, we're going in. Dark. Now, if you don't have the James Charles palette or any Morphe palette, they're pretty damn pigmented. So when you get black, it's fucking dark. So we're gonna try and oh gosh, I'm scared that this is just gonna look like I'm gonna get a black eye. Yep. This is not going well. Okay. We'll start with a different color. Since our accents are kind of silvery sometimes, usually, we'll see. Maybe. Oh my gosh. Seriously? Do I not have a silver? What is going on? I have like 100 golds, but no silver. Oh my gosh. What? What is this? Okay. Oh, we have one. Alright. First, I'm going to go into my crease with a fluffy brush using the color Cake Batter from my Too Faced Chocolate Shop. This is the New York Christmas in New York palette. I got this a few years ago for Black Friday because my stepdad's awesome and bought me like 3 makeup palettes. Just because like him and I enjoyed like walking around in Ulta and just literally picking stuff out. This one I think was Sephora only. Either way, he took me twice to like 2 different makeup stores, and he just like enjoys the way that the packaging looks. So if we both agree that like it's something that I like and it's something that I am gonna use or like really wanna try, test it out, he's all for letting me like get it because he enjoys looking at the packaging as well. This doesn't look that great right now. It's 2 years old, like 2, maybe 3 years old now. But it came in this cute little box with like the mascara and then the eyelid primer, which I didn't use this time and I should have because the one that I used is fucking trash. I don't know, it's like left like a blob here, this like shadow, which isn't a shadow, it's just like makeup isn't there next to my eye. Looks like shit. That's okay. So, get this under my eyelids a little bit. Alright. So, for this navy, we're gonna do probably like a smoky eye, maybe cut, I don't know yet. Well, we're just gonna go with it. We'll see. We will see. Wow, this is bright as shit. Okay, alright, we'll go with it. So, let's go back to this crazy navy. What is going on with my face? Okay. Alright, let's go back to this navy blue black mixture. So, we'll use more blue than black. So I'm gonna go in with the shade Cola from the James Charles Morphe palette and go right in the corner of my crease and just kind of blend towards the middle of my eye. Wow, this is not going in how I wanted it to. This look might turn out like trash. We're gonna see. We will see. All right. This brush is not my friend today, I guess. So that's pretty cool. Wow, it looks so much better on that eye, except it's going all the way up to my fucking brow bone. Okay. Apparently today was not the day for Whitney to do makeup, but you know, whatever, I guess. We're just gonna fucking go with it. I kind of wanted this to look like a little wing, but now it just looks like a blob. And they're not even the same shade. Can we, like, what? What the hell? Do you enjoy this view of cardboard? We're gonna touch that up in a minute, cause what the fuck? Okay. Okay, now I'm gonna go over lightly with the shade Spooky. Everywhere that I did the blue, the shade Cola, and just kind of hope that it kind of looks navy. Yeah? Not really. It's fine. Okay, we can't even see the shade from the toothpaste palette, the banana that I used to go all the way up to here. Ooh. So, we're gonna go back in with it to tone down the shade that got too fucking close to my eyebrow bone. I don't have a lot of eyelid, so if I put my fucking eyeshadow like this color all the way up to my brow bone, I might look like a hooker. No one really wants to look like a hooker. I don't even think hookers like their makeup. Do they even do it anymore like that? Or is it like old school? Or like, are hookers not a thing anymore? I don't know. Whatever. But now I'm gonna go in, same Too Faced palette. Wow, I hit pan on like so many of these. Holy shit. I'm gonna go in with the shade Glaze and go right under my brow bone on top of those fucking colors. Look at this. Oh my god, that's so bad. What the hell? I might just need to start over. What is this? This blend is horrendous. Oh my god. And look, that's like, ew. Can we like blend it out or fade it so it's not like fucking terrible? I straight up look like I got punched in the face. Oh. So I tried a new, it's not that new. I used to use it in the summer. Foundation, clearly, it is not my shade at all. But I really like their face wash and their moisturizer. So I tried it. Again, I used to use it. I'm very pale. It's the middle of fucking winter. Minnesota doesn't believe in the sun. So clearly, I cannot use this shade in January and probably until July when maybe I get a little color or have a little freckles because, ew. Okay. Let's try and fix this black eye moment. Maybe if I go in with like primer and correct it. Oh, that looks a little better. Okay. That's progress. All right. We'll see. It has potential. This two-tone, that does not have potential. So we're just gonna. Okay. How about this? How about we go in with the shade Playground? That's pretty light. Their blue is not that light. But it might help brighten this. No, okay, we're not gonna do it. We're gonna use the shade Flashback and go right in up here and maybe diffuse this a little bit. Oh, that did not help. Oh my God. No! Okay. Regroup. What the hell? Oh my God. Ick. I guess we're gonna go back in with that black eye color that I created, so that's fine. Okay. Yep, we're just gonna go right back in with that. Mm-hmm. And then on this eye, I guess, blend it a little more too. All right. I don't think there's any saving this look. Jesus Lord. This is rough. This is not good. All right, ew. Okay. Let's try and fix this black eye moment. Maybe if I go in with like primer and correct it. Oh, that looks a little better. Okay. That's progress. All right. We'll see. It has potential. This two-tone, that does not have potential. So we're just gonna. Okay. You know? How about this? How about we go in with the shade Playground? That's pretty light. Their blue is not that light. But it might help brighten this. No, okay, we're not gonna do it. We're gonna use the shade Flashback and go right in up here and maybe diffuse this a little bit. Oh, that did not help. Oh my God. No! Okay. Regroup. What the hell? Oh my God. Ick. I guess we're gonna go back in with that black eye color that I created, so that's fine. Okay. Yep, we're just gonna go right back in with that. Mm-hmm. And then on this eye, I guess, blend it a little more too.
All right. I don't think there's any saving this look.
Jesus Lord. This is rough. This is not good.
All right. Well, I'm gonna take my Urban Decay Primer Potion in shade Eden, which is my very favorite. Very favorite eyeshadow primer, eyelid primer. Probably can use it for, I don't know,
anything else. And just go in and kind of do a light cut crease. Just pack it on. Okay. Maybe.
Okay, so I'm using my Morphe M166 brush. All of these brushes, all the Morphe brushes anyway, I got from the James Charles collection when he released his collab with Morphe,
which I love. I had never used a Morphe brush before that. All of my brushes are just from Target. They are the Sonia Kashuk ones, and they're all about 5 years old, maybe 6 years old now. So it was time for an upgrade. I had a few brushes from Tarte because I was obsessed when they came out with their unicorns collection, because honestly, like, who wasn't obsessed with unicorns when all of the makeup companies were releasing all of their unicorn themed stuff? And like, don't get me wrong, I love them, but it was time for it to be a change.
I'm gonna go back in with this black eye color and just kind of smooth out the top of the crease. I don't like super harsh cut creases. I just don't like the way that they look. I don't think you, unless you're going to a huge event or like, I don't know. I'm just not a fan.
I like a more blended out feel, more blended out look. And I don't know.
I think they look good in pictures. I think they look good in pictures.
I just don't like them. And I don't think that most people can,
I don't think most people are comfortable wearing a look like that every single day. If you are, power to you. I'm not like that.
It's not my thing. I'm just gonna go in and blend this a little bit.
Okay. Now I'm gonna go back in.
Where the hell?
With the M124 brush in shade Flashback. And now that my eyelid is reprimed, I'm going to really pack the color on. Oof. Gonna need to blend that. That's rough.
Thank you. Okay. It's not as bad as I thought. This is rough. Okay. But that's okay. I'm gonna go back in with the shade Cola on that same brush that I used both Spooky and Cola and kind of add a little bit more blue just on the edge and like through the crease a little bit on top of that flashback color to blend it a little more. Oh my gosh, how am I? Okay. This is not the best brush to use for under your eye, but you know what? It's already got the color on it, so we're gonna go with it. Alright, now these are super uneven. If you can see, okay, this lighting is terrible, I'm so sorry. This goes a little lighter here, and this one's just like, blob. Like, it looks like I literally took my brush and was like, right there. Okay, so that's not cute, and that needs to be blended more. This primer, oh my god, I'm never using this again. It's like blotchy. And makes it super hard. Like, the creasing on my lid is ridiculous. Okay. And even sometimes when I use, like, just concealer as eyelid primer, I don't get creasing like this. I don't know. Maybe it's old, because I suck at cleaning out all of my makeup, and I honestly, keep it forever, which, ew, I know it's disgusting, but honestly, like, on one hand, I think it's really gross, and then the other hand, like, I really don't fucking care, so it's a me issue. I'm not gonna say what primer it is, because I can't really judge it, because it's kind of, ew. I don't know how old it is. I don't know if it's a new formula. I don't know. I'm really late to the game on that, so we'll just try one that I know that works next and call it a day. Why not? All right, I'm feeling it. Ew. And this, this is just not going my way at all. So I guess that's cool. Oh my god. This is not my day. All right. Now, I'm going to use another. Oh, did I use this already? I didn't. So I'm gonna go in with my M224 brush and use this silver shade that I actually found and I do have called Sugar Bells from the Too Faced Christmas in New York palette. Once I find my setting spray. Okay, so I'm gonna use this setting spray from Tarte, which is probably one of my favorite ones. I just really like the way it smells. It's like cucumber mint, I don't know. I like it, I'm gonna use it to wet my brush before I go into that silver shade, so that way it's just a little more pigmented and sticks a little better. I'm just gonna go in the middle of my eyelid, right here. Oh, it kind of looks like a little blue tint, so that's kind of nice, kind of helps. All right, sure, we'll go with it. Maybe this look can be saved. Potential, right? right. I like that. All right, so a lot of what I've seen from, I don't know, anyone that does makeup, they do one eye, one whole eye. How can I fix this? Okay. Tarte, Rainforest of the Sea. I don't even know which one this is. The first one, just Rainforest of the Sea. Sure, it kind of looks like the Naked 2 palette in comparison. It's got, like, pretty much the same colors. Like, they're kind of altered, but I'm just going to go in with my finger and go right above all of that nonsense because I'm a fucking mess and apparently woke up and didn't know how to do makeup today. So that's trash. Whatever. All right, now I'm going to take my, if I can find it, concealer brush. It's just a flat, but it looks like this. It's a Sonia Kashuk brush because I honestly love her brushes. I think they're great. And it was the first brush that I ever got, which, tried and true, loved it since. I'm gonna go in with some of my favorite concealer, the Brightening Creamy Concealer. Dream, it's like that Dream Matte Mousse collection from Maybelline, and I'm just gonna sharpen this to give it more of a point because that's just the look that I want to go for today. Potential. Okay. Ew. Oh my god. Oh right, because that side of my face is just being a fucking bitch today, I guess. Okay. Just gonna go and do the same thing on the other side. All right. Not as bad as I thought, but not as good as I wanted. Look at this, it goes like straight up. Yeah, clearly me today wasn't meant to do makeup. I don't know. I was excited. Now I'm just stressed. Mad. It's okay. It doesn't look that bad. It doesn't look that great either. Okay, that needs to be blend it out a little bit, and I'm gonna go back in with that blue and make it even, kind of diffuse it out a little bit. Let's ignore my brows because I haven't done them in like more than 3 months probably, because I'm trying to let them just grow out a little bit because I don't have them really. Like, I've got a few hairs down here, like at the tail, but this chunk right here, like where the arch, nice little bump is supposed to be, I don't have that like at all. It's just, it's not a thing. Like, it's just not there. So I really hate that. Kind of sucks. Especially when I'm like trying to draw them in and like one's like super sharp pointed, like kind of square, and then the other one just like gets a little rounded out when I like adjust it with my concealer. It's super cool. I love it. How we looking? Not that good. Not that bad. Look at all this acne. Oh my god. Okay. Anyway. All right, I think it's time for liner.
do something else. This isn't fun. It's just like... For being my favorite team, I really fucked them over, I guess, because this is pretty basic and kind of shit, so maybe on the next one I'll have a little better luck. Probably on a team like I don't like, you know? I am going to put on a little bit of mascara before I do my lash. No. Okay, we're gonna do eyeliner first. God bless, this is the most stressful part. This can ruin an entire look. You can like sit here for like 45 minutes and do like this bomb ass eye look, and then like you go to do your eyeliner and it's just like, oh, bonked, like complete shit. So let's hope that doesn't happen, because I'll be fucking pissed. I will lose my fucking mind. So I'm gonna go in with one of my top choice eyeliners for felt tips anyway, the Kat Von D tattoo liner in shade Trooper. Here we go. Wow, this is not going over that shimmer eyeshadow very well. That sucks. Okay, noted. Just got that like in my eye. This is a terrible wing. Yeah, so let's go back to Whitney can't do makeup today. Look at that. Can we just like... Oh! Okay,
I don't know.
All right, now we're gonna go in with a little bit of mascara before I put on my lashes. And this is a little tester I got from work when I used to work at Target. I say that like it was forever ago. It was literally like 2 weeks ago. Yeah, and it's okay. It's not my favorite, but for before lashes, it just gives them a little like lift beforehand, so that's good. And I don't mind the brush. It's just kind of like a generic, like, brush. I don't know. I mean, I don't know if I'd buy it again because I didn't buy this one. It's just a sample, but I really like my, stick to my favorites when it comes to mascara because they don't flake. They lift my lashes and make them look super nice. I'm just all about that. But this one's pretty good. The brush is kind of like Too Faced Better Than Sex. It just doesn't bow out as much. I don't like that mascara. It's flaky. It's not... I had a tester of it, like, this big when I got my Christmas in New York palette. I liked the way that it made my eyelashes look, but after wearing it all day, it just flaked off. I had a ton of black, like, underneath my eyelid. It wasn't cute. Wasn't a fan. So, yeah. And since I can't find my duo eyelash glue, I'm going to be using this Wet n Wild eyelash glue, which I know it holds pretty well because I used it for a Halloween costume when I was gluing rhinestones all over my body, and they stayed on all night. So,
not, I don't completely dislike it, but like, don't know if I love it either.
So
we will see. Alright, so I went ahead and did my eyelashes off camera because I'm terrible at doing lashes. And I used for my highlight, which is in the inner corners of my eyes, my nose, the bridge, and my cheeks, and right beneath my brow bone, the ABH Moonchild palette. And I mixed the shades. Oh wow, this is a disaster. I mixed the shades Blue Ice and Star. And I'm thinking it looks good. And since I don't wear lashes a lot, I stuck up with them on, and my eye keeps watering, so like now my makeup is really messed up in that corner of my eye. But overall, the look actually didn't turn out completely terrible. So I'm not completely mad at it. Could have been better, but we did okay. And now,